back to Crystallize Fab and Stitches channel. Today I'll be talking on how to make a simple shirt, or no, a simple boo boo dress or sheep dress, sleeveless. So this is our fabric on a fold of silk. Our full length is 38. I'll be using 40. 40 in the sense that 2 inches for the folding allowance and the seam allowance for the up. So this is 40. So from here, the shoulder is 14. I'll be using 7. This is the shoulder. Then I'll add 2 inches to it. So I'm using a total of 9 inches for the shoulder. Then the neck is 3. I'm using 3 for normal neck is 3. Then from here I'll slope it down. Then I'll take my armhole measurements. I'll be using 7.5 for my armhole. Where I'll place my bust measurements. This is where my bust wants to be. Then from the shoulder to 16, I'll mark out my waist. That's where I'll place my waist. That's I'll mark out a horizontal line for where I'll place my waist. Then 24, I'll use 24 for the hip. Yeah. So I'm using the bust of 35, and if you divide it into 4 will give us, I think, 8.5 or 8.25. So I'll approximately make it 9 inches plus 3 inches, because it's going to be a free gown and there is no zipper at the back. So I'll be using 3 inches plus 9. That is 12. Then the waist. The waist measurement I'm using is 28. In divide by 4 will give us 7 plus 3 is 10. So I'm using 10 for the waist. Then our hip is 35. Divide by 4 is 8.75. So I'm still approximately is 9 inches plus 3 inches will make it 12. So, like so. Then I'll cover the armhole from here. Then join the 3 points together, the bust points, the waist, and the hip. Then I'll join them like so. After which I'll cut it out. So this is the front, or one piece of it. So with this now, we'll cut out with this one now, with this subscribe to this piece, we'll cut out the back piece or another piece of it. So we have placed it on, we have placed the first one, we cut out on the first one. Next we're going to do is to cut out. That is what we're going to do to cut it out. The next thing we are going to do is to cut out. so. So this is it. So this is the two piece after cutting it out. This is what we have, the two piece. So the next thing we're going to do is to cut out the neck.
Yeah.
So for the neck, I'll be using, this is our normal neck, the one we marked out was, that's the width as 3. Then the depth for the back neck, I'll be using 2 for the depth of the back neck. Cut it out. Then for the front, it's going to have a little slit in front. So I'll be using 3 for the normal depth of the neck. Then I will use 6 for the slit. Where the slit will stop. So what I'm going to do is we cut out the first one for the front and the back. You can still give it any desirable choice of neck you want. So this is for the front neck, like so. This is the two neck. For the slits, we are going to add to this. We will make the slits while sewing. I'll show you how to do it, or how I did it, or how I'm going to do it while sewing it. So the next thing to cut out is the facing. So for the front collar, all we have to do is, this is what you're going to use for the collar. Then you just place the fabric on top of it.
Place
it
fabric on it.
You cut out. That is all you have to do. It depends on the type of collar or the size of collar you want. Some people want their collar to facing. Some people prefer their facing to be very big, but I think I love mine to be small. It depends on what I'm cutting or what I'm designing. But sometimes simple, small and simple is more finer and more lovely. So I don't have to botch. So this is the facing for the back. This is the facing for the back piece. We'll do the same for the front too. So for the front collar, just the same thing we did for the front, for the back, that's what I'm going to do. Cut it out. But you're going to leave, remember that we are having a slit in front. We left a space where we have a slit in front, 6 inches. So we'll be using the whole of this. It's not specific at all. So we'll now run our stitches as like so. Like so. So this is the facing for the front. This is the front. This is the back. So first of all, put the facing before joining. Then we have patches in front. We have 3 patches on the sides of the clothes. The next thing I'm cutting is what we use to pipe the armhole. It's just a straight stuff, so we use it for piping of the armhole. quarter, so don't worry. This is it. This is what we use to pipe the armhole. This is what we're going to use for the parts in front. So it's just a little. These are not that big, it's just more threads. So these are used and cut out another one. The parts will be three, likely three. Yeah, three. And this one is for the patch. This is the patches we're going to use on the side of the dress. So then for the pockets, because it will have an inner pocket thing. So this is a fold of two first. This way. You fold it this way again. Okay. Fold it this way. Then you place your five fingers on it, on the fabric. Place your five finger like so, then make like drops or something like this. So this is it. So we now cut out. Like so. So after cutting, this is all we have. So this is the pocket, and we'll run a stitch on it before we run a stitch on the edges, leaving this side where we're facing our hand. So the same thing we'll do it here, we'll still run a stitch here. This is for the front here. Then for that slit that will be in front, from here, this is where it will end, and this is the middle. So it should be in form of something like this. Like this, then we'll cut out. This is for the
back facing. So attach so put it in place. So the two of them will stick together. It won't budge out when wearing it. That's the essence of this ring gun. This is it. It's now well placed on top of it. But you have to make sure that your iron has enough heat for the hemming gum to stick very well. For the front part of the cloth, this is how it is after changing the color. This is what we made here to form our sleeves. So what we're going to do is, we'll use our scissors like so. So this is what we're going to do. Then you turn it out this way. This way. So after turning it out, this is what it will look like. We'll use our iron on it. Like how we attach the hemming gum to the back piece, that is how we're going to still attach this one. Then use electric iron or charcoal iron, anyone you have, to put them in place. So what we did to the other one, we'll still do it here. So after attaching the distance to it, the next thing we are going to do is to join the two shoulders. This shoulder, the front shoulder with the back shoulder. That is the next thing we are going to do. So this is the place it like so. The two shoulders. Then you stitch on it. Stitch on this side. You do the same thing to this other part of it. that the patches will attach to the main body of the clothes. It's either attached to the right side of it or you attach it to the left side. Okay, so that's what we're doing next, to attach this to the front part of the clothes. After attaching the patch, this is what it will look like. This is what my own looks like. So, this is the patch. Sorry. This is the patch using it. One, two, three. So, the next thing to do is to bend the two, folding the two, the edges of the down parts of the clothes. So, that is the next thing we are doing. After folding the down or the edge of the down, this is what we have. This we do the same thing for this other side of it. So this is what we have. So the next step we're taking is to use this stripe we cut out earlier to pipe the armhole. We use this and pipe the armhole. This we use it to pipe it inside before shaping it. So this is it. After piping it, this is what it looks like. After piping the armhole, this is the result. So the next thing we are doing is to shape. We'll shape the two sides of the clothes. So after shaping, this is what we have. This is our armhole. So the next thing we are doing is to attach the pocket seam to the two sides of it. We'll attach this pocket to it. That is the final thing we are doing.